Hi guys, it's Tara Reid. You're watching Joe and Marie all day, all night. YouTube family. Let's go!
How you doing, guys?
Hi.
Today is Saturday, November 12th. Year's just flying by. All day?
All night.
And this video, we have a bunch of vinyl from a bunch of different places. I'll tell you where I got them as we go, but we're going to just start right off and I'll show you the first one. The first one is The Missing Persons, Rhyme or Reason. I got this at Guitars and Grooves in my town. It has a little bit of ring wear on it. It's, you know, usually on black you see ring wear. It's kind of hard not to, but just on regular black vinyl. This is a original pressing. This was never re-released, but this has Closer That You Get, Give, Now Is the Time, Surrender Your Heart, Right Now, All Fall Down, Racing Against Time, Waiting for Millions of Years, If Only for a Moment. I've never heard this album. Like I said, their first album that I showed on one of the last videos, I know that album. This album is their second album. I've never really heard this album, but I bought it because I liked their music, so I wanted to check it out. See what this one is all about. See if it's going to stay in the collection. Next one is a band that I really like. They're from Kentucky. And this is
Kentucky.
And this is Knock Loose. I'm a big fan of Knock Loose. This is, I think, their second album. And I wanted to pick it up. Original price was $21.99, but they had it on sale for $15.99. And right now, Newbury Comics is doing a 20% off everything in the store. Even this weekend, they redid it. That on the 12th and 13th, everything in their store is 20% off. But I really wanted to pick this one up. It's just a regular EP. This has five songs on it, as you see. And it's The Gospel, Separate, Manipulator 2, Small Victories, and All My Friends. But that's Knock Loose, and the name of the album is Pulp Culture. I'm a big fan of them. If you're a fan of hardcore music, they're more modern day hardcore with a little bit of gentiness to it, but I really, really enjoy this one. I'd say highly check it out. Next one, I picked this one up from, I picked this one up from Newbury Comics as well. They had this one in the clearance bin. Original price on this was $50. I got it for, I think it was $27.99. But this is Daryl Hall and John Oates, Live at the Troubadour. This is a live album at the Troubadour in California. I think it's right on the Sunset Strip. But this is a 3 LP beast.
It's a fat one.
It's really, as you can see, it's a really thick, thick one. I'm going to pull these out.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But this has
a lot of jam in there.
Everything Your Heart Desires, When the Morning Comes, Family Man, Say It Isn't So, It's Uncanny, Had I Known You Better Then, She's Gone, Getaway Car, Cab Driver, One on One, Sarah Smile, Man Eater, Out of Touch, I Can't Go for That, I Can't Go for That, Rich Girl, Kiss on My List, You Make My Dreams, Abandoned Luncheonette, and Private Eyes. But
like Hit Factory.
Yeah, it's a Hit Factory, and it's on 3 black vinyls, but I really, really big fan of Daryl Hall and John Oates. I've always been a fan of theirs, so I really had to pick that one up.
And this next one.
And as a live album, it's really, really good.
And this next one is for me.
Yeah.
He surprised me with this one. I didn't even know it existed.
But this one, a guy I follow on Whatnot.
It's slightly scary, but I've never seen it before, and
yeah.
I'm glad he surprised me with it.
This guy on Whatnot that I've bought a lot of records from, his name is The Vinyl King. He's out of New Jersey. And I was on there And I was just, you know, watching his stream, seeing if anything popped up. And he showed this for like a quick second. And he asked people if anybody wanted him to run it in an auction. And I was like, run it! I know nothing about this band, know nothing about the music. He said it was rock from the 70s.
But, well, it doesn't look like the polka.
But for the sole purpose I bought this was for the artwork alone.
And the name.
Marie had to get it.
And he saw this and it screamed my name.
Yeah, and this is David Rodden Methods.
Children, look away for a second.
Bambo.
The name still gets me.
And like I said, when he showed this, and it said Bambo with Bambi with a machine gun.
And the little rabbit.
And Thumper with a knife.
A machete.
I had to pick this one up.
Oh my
but
God.
But some of the...
The songs
here. The name of the songs are My Ex-Wife, Marlena, I Deuce, Joan Crawford, Unknown Tongue, Adopt Me, Bambo, Son of Mistin, and Pimps Without Money. This album is from 1987.
Wow. That was a little tight.
Yeah. But I saw it. Even if the music stinks, because of that artwork,
it
will stay in the collection. But
oh,
it's
yeah.
on regular black vinyl. But I had to pick this up for Marie. I didn't tell her that it was coming in. And when I opened up the box, I looked. I saw it was this one. I said, Marie, close your eyes. I'm just going to hand you something, and once I hand it to you, open your eyes. When her eyes opened and she saw this, the look of sheer horror was
and
classic.
And, like, cool. I'm like, oh, my God. I wish you got that on film, actually.
But it's even funnier that you can see right there, the hunter is strapped to the Jeep in the back. So, I had to
That's the way Bambo rolls.
Yeah, I had to pick that up for her.
And I will be listening to that, like...
Probably tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Yeah. Next one. This is one I found at Savers.
Oh, she's good.
Yeah.
It's no Bambo.
This I found at Savers, and it was like a dollar and change. But I'm a big fan of her music, and this is a beautiful gatefold. And it's not technically a gatefold, but I'll show it to you.
It's cool.
But this is Roberta Flack's Killing Me Softly. I'm a big fan of Roberta Flack. And I saw this, and just the way... this record was, I had to pick it up, that
yeah.
when you look at it here,
it's like 3D.
The top of the piano opens, and then the bottom of the piano opens to show the piano, and then there's her singing.
Oh.
And the record is on the inside of this, so I thought it was really cool.
I forgot about the piano inside.
Yeah, I thought it was really cool. Like I said, I'm a big fan of her music, so I had to pick this up. But this has on it, we actually listened to this whole thing. It was pretty good.
Yeah.
It has Killing Me Softly. That's the first song on there. Then it has Jesse, No Tears, This Girl. No, sorry. I'm the Girl. River. Conversation Love. When You Smile. And Susanna. But I had to grab this one. Like I said, we listened to it. Probably the first week that I got it. Mm-hmm. And I really, really enjoyed it.
It's beautiful.
It. Yeah.
She got a great voice.
That she does.
Brand new. Factory sealed.
This one I got on Whatnot. There's a guy on there called VC Vinyl. And he had this. I really know nothing about this show. But it was a limited edition colored vinyl. And I said, oh, it probably has some good music on it. So I decided to pick it up and check it out. But this is the prime original, The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel, music from season one. This is still brand new factory seal, and as you can see in the corner, it's on colored vinyl. This is a gatefold, but I haven't opened it yet. Here's what the back looks like. Right there. But
sometimes it'll say the color of the vinyl.
Yeah, but this one doesn't, so it'll be a surprise when we open it. But it has A Wonderful Day Like Today, Come to the Market by Barbara Streisand, Who's Sorry Now by Connie Francis, Pass Me by Peggy Lee, Dance Only With Me by Blossom Dearly, What Is In It For You by Maurice Evan. Nevertheless by the Millis Brothers. Gentleman Is a Dope by Blossom Dairy. Isn't This a Lovely Day by Ella Fitzgerald. Enjoy Being With a Girl by...
I Enjoy Being a Girl.
Yeah, by Sutton Foster. You Got Trouble by Robert Preston.
Marisi Daotis, Pied Pipes.
Yep. Cry Me a River by Julie London. It's Only a Paper Moon by the King Cole Trio. And Oh Look at Me Now by Frank Sinatra. So it's a lot of 50s music. Has some older stuff like Ella Fitzgerald on here. The King Trio, they're jazz, so it's a mixed bag of stuff. Like I said, I'm a big fan of all different types of music, so I really wanted to check this one out, give it a shot, give it a couple spins. This next one I found at Savers, again, a fan of his.
Oh, and they had like four stickers right on his face. It drove me nuts.
Yeah, so Marie got him off. But I've always been a fan of his music, and this is Introducing the Hardline According to Terrence Trent D'Arby. But I had to pick this one up. This one was his first album, and it has his only real big hit, and it was Wishing Well. But on here is If You All Out to Heaven, If You Let Me Stay. It's all in cursive in the back, by the way. Wishing Well. Will Never Something My Back to You.
It's fancy writing, it's not cursive.
Yeah. Dance Little Sister. 7 More Days. Let's Go Farewell, I think it is. Rain. Sign Your Name. And As Yet Understood, maybe. And who's loving you? But let me show you the back, what this looks like.
It's fancy writing. What, I don't think it's cursive.
What I'm trying to read. It's like fancy cursive. It's like...
It's real hard, but it's not cursive.
That's what she said.
It's hard to read.
Yeah. It's not the easiest. But I'm a fan of his music. I like R&B style music. This has a little bit of soul to it. So, again, I had to pick it up.
This next one I really, really like.
Yep, this is a repress. It came out about a month ago. And I was a fan of this band back in the 80s hair metal days. And this is their first album. This is White Lion's Pride. They just finally reissued this. This is a gatefold. And it's a weird gatefold because it's a gatefold, but it's a single LP. And I don't know why they do that. Ones that should be gatefolds, that are double LPs, are not gatefolds. And ones that shouldn't be gatefolds are gatefolds. But here's what the back looks like. And then I'll open up the gatefold. You can see that 80s hair right there. And then all the lyrics for all their songs. And this one is on...
Teal.
Yeah, it's kind of like a teal color. I forgot what they called it online.
Aquamarine? No.
No, they called it something different. It
Dolphin
was,
blue?
No, they didn't even call it blue. It was an odd name for it. Like lavender, but it's not lavender. But, you know, something like that. But I really wanted to pick this one up. This one has...
Azul.
Yeah, this one has Weight on it. It has When the Children Cry. That's their two biggest hits.
That's my favorite.
Yeah. This has... I'll read the songs off of it. I should have done that while I had it out. It has Hungry, Lonely Eyes, Don't Give Up, Sweet Little Lovin', Lady of the Valley, Wait, All You Need Is Rock and Roll, Tell Me, All Join Our Hands, and When the Children Cry. But I had to pick this one up. Like I said, this is a reissue. It came out about a month ago. And I had it pre-ordered, so I was really, really happy to get this one.
Spoiler, Dolly's pre-ordered, and it comes up this week.
Yeah, it should be coming. This I got on Whatnot, again, from somebody. I can't remember who I got this from. But this is a band that I've always liked. I want to get their big album. I think it's something Fatland. But this is The Prodigy, No Tourists. This one I had to pick up. This one is a more recent album. This is a double LP. And the songs on it are Need Someone, Light Up the Sky, We Live Forever, No Tourists, Fight Fire with Fire, Time Bomb Zone, Champions of London, Boom Boom Tap, Resonate, and Give Me a Signal. But this is, I can't even see when it came out, because it's so, so tiny.
Oh, 2018.
So it's after Keith and the band died, so it's pretty much a later release of Prodigy. But it was, we listened to this, and I really, really enjoyed it. I was a fan of that
one. And you listened to every song on this twice?
Nope.
I debated about getting this, and I'm a fan of this one.
I got this.
He's trying to buy ones for me that I'll listen to get me into it.
I got this one for Marie at Bull Moose the first time we went.
It's good practice.
The first time we went, and this is Eric Church, Thief.
Bill Bradley.
But it's country, and this is on blue vinyl. But Marie wanted this because she likes the country.
And I'm like, it was like $25 or so.
Yeah. But this has on it, Creepin', Drinking My Hand, Keep On, Like Jesus Does, Hungover, Hard Up, Homeboy, Country Music, Jesus, Jack Daniels, Springsteen.
Springsteen is one of the biggest hits.
I'm Getting Stoned and Over When It's Over. But Marie wanted this. Mm-hmm. She likes her country, especially her modern country. So when I picked it up, I made sure it was a nice colored vinyl.
He's like, you should... Ugh.
So I picked that one up for her. Next one.
Oh, this is a good one for him.
Yeah.
This is like his baby.
This is a rare one. And this one was $35.99 at Newbury Comics. And this one is limited to only 333 copies.
333.
Yep. And this is Anthrax. And this is Fistful of Metal. But this is a really, really good album. It's their second, I think it's their second album that came out. Their first one was Armed and Dangerous. But it's a Newbury Comics exclusive.
They want to know what number you got.
Oh, I don't think it says it.
Yeah, it does. I think it does.
No, not on this one.
Really?
Nope, it doesn't. But they only made, it just said limited to 333. It's black inside clear vinyl. Whatever that means. But I was really, really happy for this one. This one has Death Rider, Metal Thrash and Mad, that I love that song. I'm 18, Panic. Subjugator, I can never pronounce that. Soldiers of Metal, Death from Above, Anthrax, Across the River, and Howling Furies.
And that stuff that was in the postal service, the mail?
No. Anthrax? But this is even before Joey Belladonna, when he became the singer of the band. This is when Neil Durbin was still singing for them. And Dan Leiker was actually the bassist before Frank Bello. So
you got to read more songs?
No.
Okay. I could have sworn it said the number on there because I'm like, no. You got number?
No.
No?
No, that's the that's my big box that they were talking about.
Oh, okay.
But I was really, really excited to have this one. Like I said, I'm trying to get a lot of the Anthrax albums, Armed and Dangerous, Spreading the Disease. This one I have, another one that I haven't shown yet, I have. Antisocial, Persistence of Time. Those are the main ones that I'm looking for. So, pretty much the early Joey Belladonna years and the Neil Turbin years. So, really, really happy to have that.
I'd say this is a mixed bag.
Yeah, this Definitely. One has a mixed bag of oldie style music, jazz, metal, hair metal,
whatever
country,
the heck Mambo is.
Yeah, whatever Bambo is, rock.
It's got to be a good time.
80s music. Just, you could, with this video, you could see how my taste is and what Marie likes.
I'll listen to other stuff, though.
Yeah, she does.
But, some Fear Factory is good.
Yeah, but that is everything that we have for this video. Like I said, a mixed bag of a little bit of everything, but like I said, I wanted to show these off, and a lot of them we've listened to already, and they're mm-hmm. really, really good.
Anybody heard of Bambo or seen a copy of that? I'm curious.
Yeah, I'm curious if
I haven't.
If anybody's ever heard of that. But if you like this video, hit the like button.
If you didn't like it,
videos before and after. If you want to subscribe to us, hit the subscription button, hit the notification bell, we'll have more videos for you. If you want to leave a comment down below about any of the stuff that we showed, like I said, it's a mixed bag of everything. There should be something in there that everybody would like. But until next time, guys. Bye.
Thinking about that nightmare fuel I was off to.